Hello friends, myself Akash, and in this session we are going to discuss about what is known as special data in Skype. So starting with special data, so special data is nothing but it is a representation of one's feature like location, size and its shape of the object on the earth. So this represent about the special data. And what is about non-special data? It normally represents the non-special data in tabular format. So it is independent of all geometric consideration, like if you not means if any person, mass or is any physical properties are there which is not represent, which is not dependent on location or not. So we can say that it is non-special data. So we will see through PPT. So our session objective is what will be non-special data, what is special data and what are their types. So normally data is classified into two types, special and non-special. So non-special is called as attribute data. So our special data is classified, divided into three types, which is vector, raster and team. So we will not go in deep with these all three types. We will go in what is the non-special data and what are their types. So in non-special data there are normally six types, nominal, ordinal, interval, ratio, cyclic and last one is count and amount. So, we will start with nominal data. So, we will see what is spatial data. So, spatial data primarily defined as those who are directly or indirectly reference to location of surface of Earth. As you already seen that spatial data is like examples we taken like the location of Earth, which is location, its size, shape of any object. So, this is the spatial data. And seeing about non-spatial data, so non-special data is a data in which information which is independent of all geometric representation. You can see that banks, grocery, data, insurance, these all examples are not dependent on the geometric features. So we can say that these are the types of non-special data. And here also the given mention that person, height or his mass or his age, these are non-special data because they are all independent of person's location. So any person mass is not dependent on his location. If you change the location, that mass will not change for the person. So we can say that it is non-special data. And we already told that non-special data is represented in form of table. So looking forward, there are six kinds of non-special data. One is nominal, ordinal, interval, ratio, counts and amounts. So talking about nominal data, so what is nominal data? It is the simplest type among all the six, and it is distinguished by the name to identify one entity from another entity, and there is no specific order for this. So we can include number, name, letters and everything. So how to analyze? So examples are given like place, names, name of people, its gender, nationality, name of house, numbers on a driver license, categories of land use and forest. So these are all examples of nominal category. So the next question is how to analyze this nominal data. So nominal data can be analyzed by grouping method and variables which can be grouped together and it can go into each categories, and we can calculate the frequency or percentage. So data can be also present visually such as using a pie chart. Now we will see what are the examples of nominal data. So in day-to-day life we can use nominal data in many in different varieties, but here some examples are given like calculation of GDP, job applications, e-commerce and online dating. So in day-to-day life nominal data is used, and you can see here that in online dating such platforms like they can request the user to enter some information about them so that they can match with their potential partner. So now we will see next example. Next type is ordinal or rank order. So in ordinal data it is similar to nominal, but in ordinal data observation to discrete categories which is situated in rank or order. So this act of prioritizing nominal categories transform nominal data measurement different data and the type of data in each database follows a sequence. So like if any, we can take an example like Olympics, some events or some any sportsman, they will finalize some three members which are which will be ordered in first, second or third. So this is the type of, this is an example of ordering of data, where the person, where the leaders will stand in their position, in their respective position. So here we can see the example, the three persons are standing in their respective position as a, what position they have owned. So like this is an example, we can use this ordinal level in form of education also. There are two types of education, primary and secondary. These are many types, but we can use ordinal level data in this form. And ranks put features in order from high to low. So in this example, we can see that first person is standing first position, then second and third. So in their position, where the level is being situated. So the next example is interval data. So unlike nominal and ordinal level data, which are category in nature, interval level data are numerical. Like ordinal was in categorical form, but the interval data will be seen this in the numerical form. So interval data is appearing in the form of numbers. And examples of interval level data include temperature and weather. Means you can see that any temperature, any place temperature will be varied in this particular, on particular day. On morning it will be some another temperature, and at the night it can be changing. So this is the example of interval level data. So in this example you can see that the temperature is varying. So the scale of Celsius temperature is interval. And because it makes sense to say that 30 and 20 has different types, 12 and 20 and 10. So this is an example of interval data. So the temperature in form of Celsius is varying from some particular position to another position. So this is an example of interval data. So next type is ratio data. So ratio data is also a type of interval data. And it will be also represented in the form of material. And examples of ratio level data, which include distance and area. So we can say that if you have to calculate any distance of any area of any two particular figures, so we can calculate the ratio also. And this ratio will say what is there, what will be their area, what will be their distance. So through ratio we can calculate it. So this is a type of ratio data. And the new example is given like 0 meters and 0 feet, which means, which is exactly same, just we can calculate in the form of ratio. So we call it as a ratio data. So here we are seeing what is the difference between interval and ratio level data. So the scales for both interval and ratio level data are similar, is following as a unit of measurement, they both are similar, but by calculation and by their difference, it will be, there will be some common difference. Like interval can be calculated. Now we move forward. So now we are going to see the case studies, and there are some examples of some non-special data and some related attributes. So this is one example. In this example, every district of population is given and some density is given. Now we have to calculate what was the mean population size of 32 sample districts. So there are total 32 districts, we have to calculate the mean. So for mean value, we have to calculate the total sum of this whole population and we will divide it by 32. So this is a very easy example. Next one, what is the median population size of districts? So to calculate the median, you will see the middle position. So according to this example, middle position is Stanford and another one is Rochford. We are taking 2 because it is an even number. So there are total even numbers districts, so we will be seeing 2. So it will be Stanford and Rochford. So their values are given. We will sum these 2 values and we will divide it by 2. So which will be the median of this example. Now we move forward. Example values are given like 12, 5, 22, 30. 7 and 56, 14, 42, 15, 53, So in this first rate arrange all numbers in the ascending order. And so starting with this, first we'll arrange these numbers in ascending order. So 5 will come first, then 7, then 12, then 14, then 15, 22, 25, 30, 36, 42, 36, 42, and this will be 52. Now we have to calculate the median value. So the median value is the median position of all these. So there are total 3, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 values. So median will be 5th position. No, 6th position. So median will be 22. So this is our median value. So after this we need to calculate the lower quartile and upper quartile. So lower quartile is a place which will be the left side of all these values from median, which is the left from median, and upper quartile will be the middle value from the right position of this median. So lower quartile will be this one, which will be the middle value from all this place. So middle value will be the 12, so it is the lower quartile, and upper quartile will be the middle position from this right side. So middle position is 36. So this is upper quartile. So we got these two places, and this one we have to calculate. So our lower quartile is 12. Upper quartile is 36. So same there, I calculated the lower quartile and the upper quartile. So we will move to the next question. So in this question, all the values are given in the dollar. These are all the salaries. And we need to calculate the IQR value and determine these salaries out here. So first we need to arrange this all the salaries in ascending order. So this is our from smallest to largest. So they are arranged in ascending order. So total there are 11 values. So we need to calculate the median. So median will be the 6th position. So this is the 54,000 is the median value. And we need to calculate the lower quartile, which is the Q1. So the lower quartile will be the leftmost middle value. So this is the $40,500 is the lower quartile, which is Q1. And upper quartile will be the rightmost middle value, which is $69,000. So it is Q3. Now we need to calculate the IQR value. IQR value will be the Q3 minus Q1, so which is $28,500. Now we need to multiply this value with 1.5. So we will be about $42,750. Now we will subtract this 1.5 to IQR with Q1, and we will add this value with Q3. So we got this in this value we got in negative, and this is our $111,750. So we need to calculate which is the potential out here. So our potential out here will be the value which is closest to this value. Because we can't go with negative, because salaries can't be negative and it can be less than this. So for calculating the potential out here, so nearby you are at $11,750, it will lie in this position, which will be better than 72,000, which will be less than 120,000. So the potential out here will be $120,000, which is the closest to this value. So however, 120,000 is more than this. So our $120,000 is our potential out here. So we will complete this session with this example. So thank you.